Live from Waldorf, Germany,
this is SAP Developer News.
Hello, my name's DJ, and today, for this news item, we're in Waldorf, and I've got with me Christian Georgi, product owner in the CAP team, to tell us a lot about the November release of CAP. So welcome, Christian.
Welcome, thanks for having me.
So there's a whole load of stuff that has been released and announced in the November 21 release. Do you want to take us through a couple of the items?
Absolutely, sure, thanks. So yeah, when preparing that, actually I went also through what we have just come out with, and it turned out to be really quite something, right? So most exciting could be maybe our new GraphQL adapter.
Yes, definitely.
Which is a whole new like adapter apart from like besides the REST and the OData thing. We have now GraphQL, which we can then use to leverage a whole new ecosystem of clients that want to connect using GraphQL. So
yeah,
that's really cool.
I think a lot of people want to try and kick the tires of GraphQL. This is going to be a great opportunity to, because it's so easy to create services with the CAP and then stick a GraphQL adapter on the front end.
Exactly. And that's part of the value proposition that we have. You don't need to change your code, your application. It runs as is. You can just like turn on for certain services the GraphQL adapter and then give it a try and see what you can do with it. So yeah, just give it a try. It's still an experimental phase. Not everything is supported, but quite the basic stuff and also some filters already, like dollar filter or something like that, is already in. So just give it a try.
Fantastic. And there's also some news about the REST adapter.
Absolutely. For Node.js, we have written a new REST adapter. You might ask why, because there's already one, but that new one is quite like performance optimized, and it supports quite some of the OData query options like $select, $filter, but without the like additional overhead that we have in the current OData adapter. That turned out to be quite a like historically grown code base, so we have just like taken a new step and refactored that into a new REST adapter that you can use. So quite a performance improvement also there.
Fantastic. So thanks, Christian. There's a whole load of other stuff in the November 21 release, so check it out. We'll leave that there, and we may have some more announcements next week.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So we're here in sunny Waldorf today, sort of enjoying a little downtime after putting in some long hours while shooting the developer keynote up in Frankfurt for the past couple days. We're almost done. We have one more scene to shoot, and then it's a wrap. I think I can speak for all of us when I say we had a lot of fun doing it. I can't tell you how proud I am of what the team has come up with and what's been produced so far. It's really going to be something. I had a chance to ask one of our cast members, Michelle Mowdy, about her experience over the last couple days. Here's what she had to say.
Hi, my name is Michelle Mowdy. I am a front-end dev with SAP Eureka. I have been invited to participate with the TechEd developer keynote this year, and it has been amazing. The developer advocates team that is running the developer keynote this year are a fantastic bunch of people, absolutely funny, and I have been learning so much while working with them. The production has been fantastic as well, and you've got a lot to look forward to while watching both the executive keynote and the developer keynote. I have enjoyed this so much that I hope they invite me again next year.
So, while the team is putting the finishing touches on the developer keynote, make sure you head over to the SAP TechEd registration site and register for the event. The developer keynote, session ID key 101, will automatically be added to your schedule when you register. See you then, and hope you enjoy the show.
Hi, everyone. I'm Nico, and I recently joined the Developer Advocate team. I'll be focusing on UI topics in the future alongside Marius.
Hi, Nico. First of all, welcome to the team, and thank you for supporting me with the front-end topic. And you picked a good week to start, as we have many news items to cover. The first thing is the release of the SAP OpenUX Tools GitHub repository. And this repo was developed and published by the team behind the SAP Fiori Tools extension for VS Code. They fully live the open source spirit and want to enable community collaboration to promote and facilitate best-in-class capabilities. With this project, you can use the same templates for project generation as the Fiori tools do and benefit from their expertise. On a related note, rumors also say that the team is currently working on an experimental feature switch so that you can test the most recent innovations before they are officially rolled out.
Also, this week, the first stable version 1.0 of the UI5 web components was released. This is pretty exciting news, as you can now use UI5 web components alongside the front-end framework of your choice. I followed the Getting Started guide yesterday, and I loved it.
The Service Pack Stack 0.6 comes with the early December release of SAP HANA 2.0. SAP HANA and Data Product Management Team experts bring you the What's New in SAP HANA 2.0 SPS 0.6 webinar series starting on December 7 with the overview session. It will be followed by four topic sessions after that, namely administration monitoring and security, smart data integration and native data storage extension, smart data access and performance, and multimodal and development. You can find details in the blog post from Jörg Latzer, the head of SAP HANA product management himself. And while we are on the topic of multimodal, then I hope you did not miss our last week's Devtoberfest coding challenge. In that challenge, I ask you to work with geospatial data representing SAP headquarters campus, the very same campus where I am right now.